It's hard to believe that we are here just a few short weeks after Hurricane Helene and debating the fact that we're spending billions of dollars going to unaccountable private schools in our state rather than supporting the victims of Hurricane Helene. 3/4 of the people that receive funding from these vouchers make over $115,000 a year, and 1/4 of them make more than $259,000 a year. Meanwhile, people in Western North Carolina are just now getting clean water to drink. Wake County, as you all know I represent part of, has more applicants than the bottom 60 counties combined for this program. North Carolinians shouldn't be begging for diapers and formula. We have the money to help them survive, but instead we're giving it away to the wealthiest families in our state.
I also want to offer another perspective. There are 17,902 families on the Innovations Waiver waitlist. These are families who are waiting for services for their loved one with intellectual and developmental disabilities. Services that allow these individuals to live as independently as possible, to go to work, to participate in activities, to get therapeutic services, and a whole host of other things. Some of these families have been waiting for 10 years. With what HB10 does, we could provide services to that waiver list over and over and over again, and even fund the families that are still yet to come. So I ask you to please reprioritize these dollars. Think about the constituents in your districts.
And I don't know who makes the decision to mix apples and oranges and grapes and pears and all the other stuff in there when we should be just sending the one kind of aid, and that we could tell the public we care about our citizens, every single one of them. I don't live in the mountains, and most of us in here don't, but the ones who do that need the help need it. And we should send them a strong message. It's 100%. So why give the guy from Raleigh, who doesn't live up there, a situation where he's in a catch-22, a Hobson's dilemma, or whatever they call it, where I have to vote against the aid for these people that I really, 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 really want to send to them, because we mixed some junk in here that doesn't need to be? Well, ICE is federal law, and the federal government gets plenty of our tax money to hire whoever they need to enforce their laws. They are our laws. We vote for federal people. We have 2 federal senators. What is it, 14 Congress people? They support our interests up there in D.C. And if we need more ICE agents, let them take it out of that pot. What does the sheriff have? Are we going to send the sheriffs any extra money to enforce these ICE laws for the federal government, or are we just trying to be good guys? I'd say tell ICE to do ICE's work. Need some more money? Go over there and get it from the federal government. Because my sheriff in this county is tied up. His name is Willie Rowe. He talked to me about it. He said, Abe, we don't need that House Bill 10. So if you're going to tell him to go help ICE do his job, send him some money. Send him some doggone money and show that your money is where your mouth is, and stop posturing.